Hi, my name is Megan Hamilton. I'm doing the last two parts of the presentation, the vulnerable population and a description of strategies to address the community challenges. A majority of my community lives in a lower income bracket and has difficulty meeting their family's needs. Healthcare disparities fall mainly on lower socioeconomic individuals, race, persons with disabilities, and individuals who lack education. Low education in my community is huge. There's a lot of people that you know just do not have a very high education, and it's because of they don't have money to provide for school. The vulnerable population in Alton are teen pregnancies and homeless people. Homeless individuals in Alton is growing year by year. The cost of living in Alton is below average, which is strange because that would, you know, people can't afford their living costs, but it is below average. That just shows how many jobs have been lost in Alton and how this community is decaying. There, from the windshield survey that we did, you drive down the streets and see many unkempt people, whether it be African American, Caucasian, does not matter. There are many, many unkempt people knowing that they're homeless walking around in Alton, no matter what time of the day. 10% of the houses in Alton are vacant and severely decayed. Knowing that Alton is a very small community, this is a huge, huge percent of houses. And in Alton, there's also the better parts and there's worse parts. When you walk through the worst parts, it's just sad to see all the decaying houses and people on the streets, and it's awful. So, statistic, we have had 108 arrests in 2012, and those are for controlled substances. That does not include marijuana, that does not include theft or anything like that, but it's just for drugs. So we need to start avoiding some crime. We should start avoiding some crime. But if we got the homeless people off the streets, or at least help them, that the crime rate would go down. A brief description of strategies to address the community challenges could be maybe putting job applications more available to people, because most people do not have access to computers, do not have access to getting around town. So if we could get applications closer to where the decaying parts are, the more homeless people where they hang out, to maybe get them a job and start getting their lives back together. Providing warm winter clothes for these people. We do have boxes around town where are more like, they look like huge dumpsters. And you go around town and you put old shoes, clothes, jackets, anything for these people to use and for winter months so they stay warm, especially children too. There's a few resources in the area that these people can go and take a look at. Well Springs, it's located at Alton, and it has counselors, it has some drug rehab facilities, it has many things to help people get on the right track. Crisis Food Center, these people need to get access available to good foods. They don't eat much, and when they do, it's usually not nutritious food. So getting these people back to a normal eating habit can help with less visits to the hospital, to the emergency room, because these people usually do not go to a primary health physician. They will come to the ER. And going to the ER is okay, but they don't get education on how to really maintain their life with their health, because emergency rooms just quick in and out, treat what they have going on at that time, and they're out the door. So also, and there's an Oasis shelter for women in Alton, and that provides women and children with shelter. If these women were abused or abandoned or anything and they ended up on the streets, they can go to the shelter and they can start their kids on going to school, provides them with books, toiletries, clothes, shelter. So that's another good resource for these people. And then education, I think, is just the biggest thing. Educating these people on their health and telling them how the cold environment, the not eating very good, and you don't want their children to grow up the same way that their parents are raising them. You want to make sure that their kids get a better education, better knowledge of what's going on and how living on the streets is not ideal for a life. So there's a brief description of my vulnerable population and about my community challenges. So I hope you enjoyed it.